as a special benefit. I'm doing it actually for my mastermind members, but I'll see you. Okay, let me just back off right now. I don't want to make that commitment and then back off. I'll talk about it later on. I sometimes overpromise and sometimes I have to overdeliver. Sometimes it's not possible, so I just backed off. Caught myself. Next one, the question answer session. So Q&A is very, very vital. There are 10 keys to drive a great question answer session. And I'll just tell you a mistake quickly, what most people do. Never ask the question, do you have any questions? That's a mistake many people do. Rajesh asked me the question, what's the secret to your energy yesterday? Was it yesterday or day before?
Day before on the call.
Before that, I said something. I'll not go into all the 10 techniques right now, Q&A. I said something, but I did not say, if you listen to the recording, if it was recorded, I did not say, do you have any questions? I said, what questions do you have for me? Big difference. Don't ask, do you have any questions? Because at that time, it's a yes or no. Do you have any question for me? Yes or no. What questions do you have for me? It's like, I know you have questions. What questions do you have for me? Has there ever been a time where you ask a question and you say, do you have any questions, and nobody asks a question? Ever happened to you, Nagesh? How does that make you feel as a speaker at that time?
I feel they've already connected and understood, or they have understood nothing.
By correct. And we are confused at that time whether they have understood. But when I say, what questions do you have? And I'll later on show you how, what body language to use at that time that can instantly generate more questions. I'll tell you another quick trick. If you can get people to ask question one time, the second question is easier from the audience. Everybody is afraid to ask the first question. Okay? Yeah, you were saying something?
Okay,
we're not done yet. Okay. So, about that?
Yeah.
Just a few minutes. Question, quote, catchphrase, Q&A. The fifth is end with an activity. End with an activity. All right, end with an activity. Meaning, just get them to write something, or even if I say, hey, let's review together, you review and say, what was the best thing that you learned? See, that's an activity. I'm getting the audience to be active with me. That's a brilliant way to end a presentation. Jayaprakash, you getting it?
Yeah.
Okay. These are the five ways. But I like to sometimes over-deliver. So I'll tell a bonus way, sixth way. Write this down, six, a special way. If this is the bonus way, is the final, like, extra way to end a conclusion or end a presentation, and that is to remember this. I'll tell you the technique, but you want to leave the audience always on a high. The mistake many people do is that they start this way and then the energy goes down, 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 down. Correct? Have you ever seen that they're like very pumped up, but toward the end, like, yeah, answering question, yeah, fine, fine, yeah. Any more question? No question? All right. Yeah, let's go. All right, thank you, sir.
Yeah.
You want to leave them on a high. So the way to do it is write this down, inspirational factor. Anytime you are giving a non-technical presentation, you can leave them on a high and inspire the audience. I call it inspirational factor. We'll talk more about it later on, but that's a way to end a presentation very powerfully, which is through inspirational way. Now, music is set up that room? So here's the deal. Was it a good day so far?
Yes.
All right. Next, practicality is where we start. So, to make that happen, we'll divide the room. Rajlakshmi will be with me for the few hours. Akash will be with Pramod. I'll tell you how the room works. Now, for the next 15 minutes or 20 minutes, we shift to that room, and I'll tell you why. All of us, including me, we'll go to that room. We'll shift to that room, and for the next 15 minutes, what's the time now? 12:50?
12:50.
Till 1:05 approximately. I'll maximum give 20 minutes. I want you to go to that room, review your notes, and at that room, practice your presentation for at least 4 to 5 minutes. Let me give you quick guidelines. Can you just sit down for a minute?
Yeah.
Distracting me. Thank you. So for the next 15-20 minutes, what you're gonna do is practice your presentation. How many of, be honest, which is fine. Akash will help you in that case. How many of you don't have a topic set for today's presentation? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ask Akash for some topic. Give them something generic. Don't go with data storage algorithm for today. I'll tell you right now. It's going to be tough for you to implement. It's going to be tough for audience to understand. Take something generic topic. Not very generic, something that people will understand. Example, how many of